Good morning to everybody. How are you? I hope you all are fine and waiting for your next class. I am P.K. Srivastava from KV number 1, Rewa. Today I am here to discuss the third important topic of wave optics, which is diffraction of light. Diffraction is the property of wave, and as you know, light is wave, so it also possesses the property of diffraction. In this topic, we will discuss about various points such as what is diffraction of light, next, condition of diffraction, in which condition diffraction occurs, cause of diffraction, single slit diffraction, single slit diffraction, and in single slit diffraction we will study in detail about the diffraction pattern, theory of diffraction, intensity variation, positions of maxima and minima, and so on. Next, we will discuss about the difference between interference and diffraction. You studied interference in previous videos. Then we will discuss the Fresnel distance, and then concept of dissolving power, we will take the case of resolving power of microscope and telescope. So there are large number of topics, many topics. We will discuss in first video what is diffraction of light, condition of diffraction, cause of diffraction, and one more topic, types of diffraction. And then in next video we will see single slit diffraction in detail and other topics. So we take one by one these topics, these subtopics. First one is, what is diffraction? You are familiar with the nature of light. You know that light is wave. You studied the Huygens wave theory, Huygens principle of secondary wavelets, etc. in previous videos, and you also know that light travels along a straight path. Yes, All of you know that light travels along the straight path. But experimentally it is found that under certain conditions, light waves can bend or diffracted. The bending of light waves or diffraction of light can be easily understood by simple experiment. Suppose there is monochromatic point source of light and in the path of light there is a small slit AB and we place a screen here. XY, this is our screen. If light travels along the straight path, then it will go straight along this path, and the portion PQ should be illuminated and there should be no light in the region PY and region QX. These are the geometrical shadows. But experimentally it is found that some light enters in this region PY with decreasing intensity. It is possible only when the light waves coming from the slit are bending from these sharp corners of slit. Similarly, if we take again point source of light and there is a small opaque obstacle in the path of light, again we place a screen XY at some distance. If light travels along this along the straight path, then it will go straight like this. And in the region PQ, there should be no light, that is dark, and light can enter only in this region PY and QX. But experimentally it is found that some light enters in the region PQ here with decreasing intensity. It happens only due to bending of light around the sharp corners of this obstacle, opaque obstacle, AB. This phenomena of bending of light is known as diffraction. So now we can define diffraction of light. The phenomena of bending of light around the sharp corners of slit or obstacle is called diffraction of light. Thus, that is phenomena of bending of light around the sharp corners of obstacle or slit is called diffraction of light. Due to this diffraction, some light enters in geometrical shadow of slit or obstacle. That is, light encroaches in the geometrical prohibited region of obstacle or slit. But generally, the diffraction of light is not common because there is necessary condition for diffraction of wave. For the diffraction of wave, it is required that the size of obstacle or slit is of the order of wavelength of the wave. All of you know that the wavelength of light wave is of the order of 10 to the power minus 6 meter, or we can say micrometer, and obstacle or slit of such dimension is not easily available. So diffraction of light takes place rarely. But in case of sound wave, radio waves, the wavelength is much larger. So diffraction of sound wave, radio waves is more common. Suppose there is a slit of width small d, and this is light wave having wavelength lambda incident on this slit. Then after coming out from this slit, there is less bending if lambda is less than the size of this width. But if the size of slit is reduced and this is incident light having wavelength lambda, then after coming out it is diffracted more. Here lambda equal to d, and if size of slit is very small and this is incident wavefront, incident light, then after coming out from this very narrow slit the diffraction increases. Here d is less than lambda. So in this way we can see how the wavelength of the wave is important for the diffraction of the wave. Now we see what is the cause of diffraction. What is the cause of diffraction? According to Fresnel, the diffraction of light is due to superposition of secondary wavelets coming from different parts of same primary wavefront. Here the word same primary wavefront is important. Same primary wavefront which is not blocked by slit or obstacle. This is the basic cause of diffraction. Fresnel studied in detail the diffraction and gave correct explanation for the diffraction of light wave. Now we study how the diffraction pattern, diffraction of light can be studied. As told earlier, the diffraction of light is not common. It occurs rarely. It can be studied in laboratory. So there are two types of diffraction. First one is Fresnel diffraction, in such type of diffraction either the source of light or screen or both are at some finite distance from the slit or obstacle. Such type of diffraction is known as Fresnel type diffraction. For example, diffraction at straight edge diffraction at a thin wire diffraction at a small opaque object. The second one is Fraunhofer type diffraction. In such a diffraction, both the source of light and screen are at infinite distance from the slit or obstacle. Both the source of light and screen are at infinite distance from the slit. For example, diffraction due to single slit, diffraction due to double slit, and diffraction due to diffraction gratings. These are the devices which are used for making the which are used to study the diffraction. So there are two types of diffraction, Fresnel and Fraunhofer diffraction. A question arises in case of Fraunhofer diffraction, when both source of light and screen are at infinite distance, then how can it be performed in laboratory? So suppose this is point source of light and it is placed at the focus of convex lens L. When the source of light is placed at the focus of this convex lens, then the light emerging from lens or reflected from lens will become a parallel beam of light, and corresponding to parallel beam of light, this is plane wave front, and when the source of light is at infinite distance, then the wave front will be plane wave front. So here the source behaves as that it is at infinite distance from this slit, suppose there is slit AB. For this slit AB, the source behaves as infinite distance. And similarly, when a plane wave front, this is plane wave front, parallel beam of light is incident on another convex lens, then they are focused at the focus. So if we place a screen at the focal length of this convex lens, then the screen behaves as it is at infinite distance. So in this way we can study the Fraunhofer diffraction in laboratory. So this is all about the elementary concepts of diffraction. Here I want example from daily life. If a person at a very large distance looks at mountain just before the sunrise, he observes a luminous border surrounding the profile of mountain. This is due to diffraction of light. Now, before closing this today's topic, there are two questions. You try to answer yourself. First question is, why do we not encounter diffraction effects of light in everyday observations? Whereas the diffraction of sound is more common. The second question is, suppose there are two persons, A and B, standing on the two sides of a partition wall in a big hall. Suppose size of this partition wall is about 8 feet. Then person A and B can hear one another, but they cannot see each other. These are the two questions. I hope that you will answer after completing today's topic. And thank you. I hope that this video would benefit you.